No.
That's not something you say every day on a footy field.
We've got Jai Thompson, who looks like some sort of mummy as well, in the restart. He's
got plenty of tape wrapped around that head.
Plenty of tape around the melon.
I think he just puts it on at half time anyway.
He's a little bit like Joel Selwood.
He's a lot like that.
Always got something going on.
Well, he's always at the bottom of the pack, isn't he?
He is. As the umpire throws it up, it's going to be Hovey and Berry. Yeah, they've done most of the day go up. It's Berry again. He's probably had the better of Hovey in the ruck today. And it is Thompson again. Jai gets it out of the middle, but Lovick dashing off half-back beautifully. Just paddles a boy in front of him. Jacko Davis gets a little 1-2. That was pretty. Gets it forward now. Inside 50 for Joey's. It's Paul Carson, who's getting plenty of the football. Gave it off to Haynes. Haynes with a right foot snap, close to the boundary, and a wonderful mark taken by Hayden Foss.
Bingo reading of the flight there.
Maybe. He's taken some nice marks today and a lovely little spot up as well, and he's found Reece Holmgren.
He's a player too that really could have an influence in the second half. We've barely sighted him in the first half, Reece Holmgren. Hasn't done a lot. If he can have an influence up four, there's just another potential goal kicker for St. Joey's, and
absolutely
really help him press on for me.
Important first goal this. He's tucked hard up against the boundary though. Kicks on the right foot. Nice approach, but it's to the right of the big sticks. Just the one behind. St. Joseph's tick along. 7-7-49. Leading Leopold 5-7-37. So two straight kicks for 40 winks.
He's kicked 16 goals, is it, Reece Holmgren? And you're right, Jim. Hardly called his name today. He's pinched hitting the ruck a little bit, but hasn't got a lot of the footy so far. But you're right, if he gets going, look out.
So Leopold, they can bring the ball back into play. Go out wide. Berry read that one very poorly in the air. Hovey was able to sweep across and take the mark. He dangerous kick back in board. Taken by Davis. Quickly plays on. Gets on the left boot. Kicks it to a dangerous position. Trying to get across there was Carson. Couldn't do so. Spills out the back. Haynes left the ball behind. At ground level now. Going in again was Haynes. But then eventually the boundary line beats them all. We'll have a throw in. It's about five around from the right hand side point post that St. Joey's attacking end.
Reece Holmgren was hit with a nice hip and shoulder there that bundled him across the line. I'm not sure who actually performed that, but it's good tough stuff from Leopold.
Big hit. The ball's thrown into play. Berry's got the front position. He's going up against Holmgren on this occasion. Just trying to get him involved in the play. Came straight to ground level, and the umpire is going to call for it. We'll have a ball up. About 15 out from goal. St. Joey's doing all the attacking early.
Matty's just left the box to just show how tough he really is. Well, just out in the cold, I like it.
He's going to get the tracky dacks is what he's done. It's a shot on goal, though, from St. Joseph's, and it's missed to the right-hand side again.
Early on, we commented about how wasteful Leopold were. They kicked, I think, four behinds it was before they may have kicked a goal or something along those lines. All of a sudden, that behinds column's evened up, just showing Joey's waste, a little bit wasteful.
Spot on. So Thompson restarts play, kicks long. It's a poor attempt to mark by Nick Burke. He's got his hands all over the back there of his opponent. And it's Alex Hickey. And Hickey is just going to kick short, find his teammate, and Foss again. Foss chips it up to the goal square. Tap through, though. It's actually gone out of bounds. Well done, Jez Larkham, in the air. And they're under some sort of pressure here, Leopold.
Yeah, they're holding on for dear life at the moment, the Lions. Joey's are coming hard, as you'd expect them to. Proud side that they are. So the ball will come back in. That ruck contest was halved somewhat. The ball comes out as a whistle. Which way
Leopold.
Is it going? It's going Leopold's way. So Matty Miller in the long sleeves this afternoon. Still well in his own half. He should just pump this down the line for safety, and does. He comes out to this side, the commentary side. Drives it towards the wing, but Hovey always had that.
Three on one.
He was in best position. You're right, it was a poor kick. While the numbers had to be on this side, it was the only place the kick was going to go. Leopold, slow to react. Hovey will pump back into his own 50. It'll make it just. Looking for Carson over the top. How's them for hands against Jeremy Larkham?
Terrific mark, that one. Sticky and strong. Larkham actually got a fair piece of that footy. And Carson, and I'm marking that one straight down for Palais Bingo mark of the day.
Now, I just want to mention too, while that kick from Leopold trying to clear our defence a minute ago, did it need to be closer to the boundary line? Do you prefer it, you know, a bit tighter along the line, so if they do have the opportunity to kill the footy instead of having the intercept mark?
Well, I actually just think it was a poor kick. It was to a 3-on-1. He had plenty of time. You don't have to kick it, you know. He could have chipped short. He could have actually tried to handball to a teammate running past, and it's actually cost him a goal in the end because
Carson's finished off his strong mark.
He's made no mistake, so disappointing play that, I thought, out of half-back. For 40 winks, the scoreboard ticks over. 8-8-56. St. Joseph's leading Leopold 5-7-37. She's out to 19 points and all important. Next goal, I would have thought.
Yeah, very important. As the ball makes its way back to the centre, it'll be Berry to go up in the ruck. He gets the tap, taps it straight to Kerr's. He got the ball moving forward for Joey's. He found Foss. Foss tried to give it off, eventually held on to it. Kicks out wide to the pocket. Good defending, though, from Leopold as they take the intercept mark deep in defence. Paul Carson just not in the greatest positions in that contest. Now the kick goes short to Sammy Hughes. He's got about 30 out from the Joey's goal. He brings it out wide. Taking the mark there is Matthew Pitt. Moves it on further afield. They can try and run Leopold, and something they haven't had a lot of today. But great chase from behind. That's Reece Holcomb getting involved in the game. They take the advantage of St. Joey's. Probably wasn't a right decision, Jay. He was under pressure, and eventually he's been wrapped up in the tackle.
Another shocking advantage. That's a third really poor advantage paid. Yeah. For the day.
Yeah, there was no advantage there whatsoever. The handball came out quickly and then they were just tackled. There was no advantage whatsoever. But Berry wins it down, but it's won by Joey's, and they'll pump it in through Jimmy Allen. It's an end-on-end sort of ball. Carson does well, just gather it. Have a look at the strength of the man. Ends up getting it out, and the shot on goal is good. It's Holcren, that man we speak of, Jim. He's lit up in this third term.
He's had plenty of involvement,
and
hasn't
he kicks it, and the margin on the 40-inch scoreboard is eased out to, what does that make it, 25.
Yeah, it's not great signs for Leopold at the moment, especially we did say Holcren. He has had plenty of it in this term.
They've just got hold of him here, Joey's, and I've actually marked that one down for the East Fruit Market goal of the day too. Not only Holcren's snap, which was a ripper, but Paul Carson's work beforehand, just to shrug a couple of tackles with strength and dish it out to him.
Yep.
Getting a little bit generous on the East Fruit Market, I think, bub.
I thought it was really good footy there.
Clutching at straws.
Really? Yeah. Nah, it was good footy. The hot chips come in.
Yeah, how's that?
You're beauty. So it's Hovey and Berry. Once again, it's Berry again over the top. Down to Miller. Miller kicks the ball well inside 50. And Lovick goes back with courage. Well done. Slipped over as he tried to kick it was Jackman. Didn't get much on the footy, unfortunately for him. Ball's outside 50, though, and it's just going to trickle out of bounds. And umpire says, give it to the boundary umpire. He'll throw that thing in.
Yeah, so Leopold, really, for the first time in this second half, in a dangerous position. They'd hope to get a good clearance here. Berry will look to get a tap to one of his midfielders in the ruck here. Come from the front, that was Walker. He tapped it straight to Reed Adams. He got the ball moving forward. Now trying to charge through there is Haynes. He keeps the ball moving forward, but Leopold through Sam Hughes. Get caught up in the middle of the ground. That's the... What do we reckon there? That's about the fourth or fifth really hot hole in the ball we've seen today. It'll be Haynes to take the free kick, and Joey's looking really dangerous. Moves it on quickly. He's got a strong lead from John O'Casey. He takes the mark. He's about 80 out from goal. He's got Carson on a good lead as well. He's going to hit him out.
Poor period for Leopold. They've just got to steady up here.
Yeah, so Paul Carson with the ball. Gets it moving quickly into the pocket. Strong mark taken. That's Kerr's there. Taken above his head, and he's about 20 out. Tight angle, though, but way Joey's are going, you wouldn't be surprised if he goes back and slots it.
Yeah, not from what I've seen so far with his right boot.
I'm tipping him to go against everything you've said about him today. Right, previous shots of goal.
It's back a tight angle.
He's tried something a little bit fancy. He's gone the right foot banana, and how about that one?
That is a ripper, and I'll mark
East
that
fruit
down as well.
Thank you very much.
Absolutely. So Geordie Kerr is tight on the boundary line.
Top that well.
Left-hand side of the sticks. He's just wandered out and done this banana.
I reckon the car next to him had had us up on the radio there. We backed him in, and away he went.
That was a ripper, and probably got Holcren for East Fruit Market goal of the day, has he?
He's pipped him. Yeah. I reckon that covers Holcren. You can cross his out.
Right. Gotcha.
I was just looking. Matty Miller was the spare with that contest. He was in the middle of the 50, and he wasn't guarding any dangerous space. Carson was always the go-to man for that out in the pocket, and just got lost there.
So ball bounce. It's Jai Thompson trying to get it back in Leopold's favour. He got it out to Berry, and Berry got it inside 50 for Leopold. They need something here. They're tracking the footy. It was at the base of the pack there, Kevy Burke. He couldn't get the ball out. It's willing. It's hot in there. And it's going to be Joey's who get it out. But no, ball gets sucked back in. All sorts of stuff happening at the bottom of this pack. Leopold sensing the urgency of this situation. And they just force a stoppage. The umpire will restart play about 60 out from their goal.
Great pressure here. Leopold, they really needed to make a bit of a response at the moment. They are down and out, 31 points trailing Joey's at the moment. The tap wasn't a bad one. Foss in on hands and knees, diving in on top of the footy. He's going nowhere, though. The umpire called for an immunity. You wouldn't have thought. Hopefully we don't see another one of those on the ball decisions. But eventually we get a ball up. 55 out from the Leopold goal. They need something from this stoppage and they need it now. Berry though, he's strong in the ruck. Tried to get the tap. Beating him though on that occasion was Hovey. Eventually though, now they get the kick going forward through Burke. At the back was Tom. He's almost taken a great contested mark there. Goes to ground level. He picks it up and he stands up. Handball's off. Now it comes out the back. The kick smothered well by Lovick. They can try and work it out there. Hovey handballs it back. Now Lovick's got it again. Gets it on the left as he's tackled. His kick only went as far as Pitt, who centres it back inboard. And Leopold will end up with the mark and the shot at goal.
Well, a couple of things there. A terrific smother from Daniel Lovick on Daniel Pitcher. And then straight back at him, Daniel Pitcher with a wonderful chase to just bring down Lovick and affect his kick. It went to Pitt. And Pitt then has got it onto his teammate.
And Darcy Keast.
And he'll line up for goal.
Not cassette or something like that. Definitely
the old cassette tape.
The old cassette tape, yeah. So Keast. Have to be a good kick from here. A kick from just inside the paint. He gets to about 45. He'll give it a roost on the right boot. It's not looking bad. The umpire's hit the deck and it's gone off hands. And he's got no idea, the umpire, what's happened there. He had his face in the turf. He's gone to the boundary umpire for a bit of advice. I reckon that was clearly touching over there.
Well,
over the line.
Leon Balls are giving some advice.
It's a goal. No, touched. So kicked out from measures anyway. So the ball was touched. A little bit stiff there. He goes on to Ferguson. Ferguson, who just went missing a little bit there in the second quarter, clears it out of halfback, gets it to Capra. Capra further afield, and they are running beautifully here. Ball ends up with Foss, who's been very exciting this quarter so far. Sticky hits from McCool. He was smashed to the ground by his opponent. Still got the footy, though, have St. Joseph's, and it's Reed Adams who goes in there and bustles his way through the pack. Somehow, Foss again finds himself out the back. Strong work from Paul Carson. Gets rid of his opponent. It was a little flip back. It was deft touch. Picked up the ball was Timmy Arnell, and Arnell has missed
that
to the right hand side.
That deserved to go.
How good was that?
That was nice, wasn't it? That's knowing where your mates are, isn't it?
That was pretty. So Darcy Keast is going to get this on half back from the restart, from full back. Kicks it further afield, and a nice attempt at mark. Couldn't quite take it there was Nick Burke. St. Joseph's get back possession of the footy through measures. Snaps around on his right, but the ball smashed out of bounds.
It was well done by measures. He didn't have a good position at all. Then Burke had to sit and just did enough to he didn't probably didn't get a hand to the footy, but did enough to influence the contest and stop Burke from taking the mark. And I suspect Burke might have been covered for pace too. So it was well done.
Big 5 minutes here for Leopold once again. At the base of the pack, though, it's Alex Hickey. Got it out there to Kerris. Kerris just smashed it forward on the boot and in best position and taking a wonderful mark. I think that's Dale Carson, isn't it, boys?
Looks like him. No, it's Joey McCoola
on the chest.
And we know Joey loves a goal.
Yeah.
There will be a little bit of look at me time if he kicks this.
Yeah.
Look for the celebration. But that
wonderful
was great. Buzz, I'll just get you to prepare around the grounds. Little score line here for Gateway Hotel while he's coming in.
Yep.
If he slots it, we'll go straight to it. So McCoola, he's about 40 out, 45 degree angle. Trundles in. He's hooked that badly, though. To the left. The minor score, margin on 40 wink scoreboard at 21 though.
Yeah, not his best attempt there. Just hit the inside of the boot and was offline very early on.
We'll just get one quick one for you, Buzz. A close one.
Yeah, Newtown just 1 point behind Grovedale now. Grovedale have taken the lead 2 minutes into the third term.
Quickly, the St Albans score as well.
The St Albans score, they are 8 points behind Colac, 11 minutes played.
Right, two good games there. Ball's brought into play. Leopold, but it's ended up with St. Joseph's here. It's Kerris, gets the handball to Jackman. To Foss it was. Foss just pumped it inside 50. Off hands, nicely done here. I think it's Arnell, just wheeled around to the right. Finds again, that's Foss. He's everywhere. And he misses everything though, and the ball goes out of bounds on the opposite side of the ground.
I'll tell you what, Foss in this second half is quickly working himself into contention for a couple of votes later on, I would have thought.
He is, isn't he? Ball thrown back into play. It's Darcy Keast doing the ruck work for Leopold. Unfortunately for him, though, Foss is looking dangerous again. He didn't get it, though. Ball went further out to Jacko Davis. Davis just goes around on the right. Dangerous here. Holmgren got his hands up. Couldn't take the mark. It was a free kick, though. Umpire's paid a hold.
Yeah, going against Joe McCoola against Jai Thompson.
Just tackled him before he took possession of the ball, and
so
he never ended up taking possession of the ball on occasion.
Just relieving the situation here. Goes further afield to Pitcher. Pitcher on half back. They're just building something. They've slowed down the tempo a little bit here. It's Bennett, a long way from home. Umpire calls in a play on. He's going to transfer play across. The kick to McHenry. Made him work for it. He took a good mark. He just goes off his line. The umpire says play on again, and it's Kevy Burke. Just spots him up. Wheels straight along. On the right foot. Looking for Tom. Well done again, Capra. Affected the spoil. Jacko Davis across to Lovick. Transfers play across to the outer side of the ground. Very wide out there. John O'Casey got his hands on it, but the boundary line beats him.
So Jason Tom got some nice delivery from Kevy Burke for one of the first times this afternoon, but didn't extend his hands as he would have liked. Went to get it on the chest and gave Capra a chance to affect the spoil.
So Joey's can get the clearance through Hickey. They'll get the kick going forward. At the front there was Carson. He couldn't get into a position to hold on the mark. Now they can clear the ball out of there. Foss was in there laying some pressure again. Guy Keefe handballs it off to Jai Thompson. Gets on the left as they come through the centre of the ground. Out wide, taking the mark. There's Hardy. He's about 55 out. He's going to bring it back into a dangerous position.
And great kick.
Tom's just lost Benny Capra there a little bit. Takes the mark, probably 35 out, I would have thought that might be.
Really nice kick from Greg Hardy. He's been extremely quiet today, but that was...
It was good vision, wasn't it?
Wonderful vision.
He noticed that Tom had just lost Capra and kicked it to that space for him to move into.
Big kick, boys.
Huge kick. Two goals, one this afternoon. Jason Tom looked to make it 3-1. Keep his team alive in this contest, you'd have to say. Comes in. The Cars are doing their best to put him off, and he has absolutely munged it.
That is one of the worst drops of the footy you can see.
Yeah, he dropped it from about his ear, and the ball didn't really spin. It went through for a behind. Lucky to make the distance in the end.
So Jackman goes out to Latore. Latore just tracking along the boundary line. Finds Jackman up there somehow. So obviously wasn't him kicking out from full back. Eventually the ball's with Capra. Capra right in front of us. Give us a wave, son. He kicks it on the right along the boundary line. Looking for and finding Foss. He has been excellent overhead today. Foss wheels around on the right. Sees a target in Carson, Paul, and Paul with commanding mark from Paul Carson. He's had a wonderful day as well. Just chips into the centre of the ground, and their foot skills are elite at the moment, and they're threatening to put an end to this game early, St. Joseph's, and he's found his teammate, and it is going to be Brant Haynes.
Yeah, wonderful from Carson. Most people would expect him to just drive it towards the goal square, but wonderful vision to square the play up to Haynes.
So Haynes, you're going to kick from about 40, not much angle, and that's a lovely looking kick, and that is lovely play from St. Joseph's. Really good play there. Just showing exactly, they've just got the chest out here. Really pumping it.
They're really making a bit of a statement, aren't they?
They are, and they move along to 11-9-79.
This has been the sort of quarter you come to expect from a premiership favourite.
11-9-75, I'll say. The scoreboard attendant was a little bit slow there. And get out of the way, son. I can't even see that. It's 5-9.
5-9.
Help me out with the final score then. 39.
39 at the B-Bomb. It's a ball. Come back up. It's the two relief ruckmen at the moment. And Holcomb wins it down. Tackled quickly was Miller. Couldn't quite get a quick clear disposal. McCullough's kick was partially smothered and it goes towards the outer side, winning that race as Michael Murray gives it to Hughes, but he attracts Timmy Arnell his attention pretty quickly. Dreyer handball over the top. It's into space and it'll work, and they'll square the ball up in the middle of the ground, and Carson had the sit. This is Paul this time. They're just extracting the PI55, the Carsons at the moment. They are having their own little ball at the moment.
Waiting to see where you're going with that.
He's proved to be a very tough matchup, Paul Carson.
Yep.
I think we're nearly due for a change there.
He's a tricky size, isn't he? Because he's good at ground level, but he equally is good in the air. So slight angle for him, but should be no worries.
Just to blow the margin out to 7 straight goals, lads, in the blink of an eye.
Comes in Paul Carson, steady approach, easy as you like. Thank you for coming. His second for the afternoon and number 31 for the season, believe it or not. And Joey's, as you say, they are really showing their authority now. They move on to 12-9-85. Leopold still 5-9-39 on the 40-wing scoreboard.
Yeah, well, They are showing what a good side they are. And I mentioned whether they can go through the year undefeated. And you see like little periods like this and you think, wow, they are a pretty strong unit. They play for each other. They transfer the ball really well. Their foot skills are also good. As the ball's bounced up again, it's Berry. Second go at it. Cracks it out in Leopold's advantage. But it's going to be St. Joseph's once again. And it was Hovey bullocking the ball forward. Ball though. Everyone on their knees. It's Berry now for Leopold. Got his hands on it. Tried to extract it out of the pack, but he attracted a crowd. The umpire says, give it to me. And they'll bounce it up again. One would feel this game's just about over, though. Unfortunately, it was an entertaining first half as it's hacked forward by O'Keefe. O'Keefe has found Thompson, who's tried hard all day, no doubt. Jai Thompson. Can't spot up a target. He does eventually, though, and it's Jai Walker. Walker immediately onto the left foot, goes long. Couldn't find a teammate, though. Running onto it, O'Keefe. O'Keefe, Lovick lays a good tackle on him. Ball inside 50 for Leopold. Umpire says, give it to me.
It was good by Jai Walker. The quick delivery didn't allow Lovick to get back. He was free, Dan Lovick, but the quick movement didn't allow him to get back. He didn't need to do that more often.
Absolutely. Smashed out of the ruck by Greg Hardy. Just knocked it his way. But it was Lovick who just hacked it off the ground, found his teammate Measures. Measures further afield, couldn't quite find Jimmy Allen. And the ball has been adjudged out of bounds. About 60 out from Leopold's goal. Russell Pavilion side of the ground.
So the ball gets thrown back into play. Berry will work his way to the front. Taps it back towards the boundary line. Walker tries to get there first, but beating them, him there. Look
Davis.
Like Davis maybe, yep, it was Davis. Kick up the ground wasn't a bad one, and now Joey's, they've got numbers everywhere, and the kick going into the inside the forward 50, found Casey, marks about 45 out. They have to give it a fair roost from there, but he seems confident as he pushes back off the mark.
Yeah, this is a procession now. I mean, off half back there, three beautiful kicks into the hands of John O'Casey.
How was a delivery from Paul Carson?
It was magnificent.
He'd love to be running into that every day.
Dale Carson it was, yeah.
So Casey makes his way in. He's going to have to give it a fair ride, and the man on the mark puts a bit of pressure on him as he hooks the kick, searching for that extra distance, and it just makes its way through for one behind and on the 40-wink scoreboard. St. Joey's 12-10-82. Really just putting a bit of an advantage on the scoreboard as Leopold left at 5-9-39.
So it'll be Marcus Thompson to bring it in as Leopold trying to rise themselves out of the doldrums, but it's looking increasingly difficult. Dale Carson should mark this and does. He was just sitting in the space where he thought the ball might go. Intelligent. He drives it and squares it a little bit. The fist came from Burke, and the ball falls over the back and escapes Casey because Jeremy Larkham, with no other intention other than to belt the ball out of play, does so.
I'll tell you what, very poor kicking. Why you kick it straight to a man in Dale Carson? He's kicked through today and shown how good a mark he is.
Yeah, look, he was looking for Jack Berry's ruckman, but the kick wasn't anywhere near long enough for him, unfortunately. As the ball's restarted anyway, it's at ground level. It's going to be a Leopold player who's going to get it out there, and they're away at halfback. Jai Walker, just with a nice little step, takes a bounce now. This is good. This is the build-up they need. Just goes a little one on the right, a dinky little kick. I think it was meant for Tom. Wasn't great, though. Capra just held him out of the contest and allowed Latore just to get the footy. Latore goes further afield to Jacko Davis. Davis was under a bit of pressure but managed to get a nice right foot kick to it. Carson flew from behind three deep. Ball goes on to Holkren. Holkren just with an underground handball, and it was nice. It was a good clean pick-up there from the Joey's player as well further afield. They've still got control of the footy here. It's Kerris, heard a teammate, and it was Holkren. Holkren on the left foot, goes looking for goals, but it's marked in the goal square, and I reckon that's Paul Carson, boys.
It is.
Oh.
It certainly is.
He has just been a genuine handful today.
And that was the work by Joey's there then. They just kept the ball moving. They didn't let Leopold tie it up. They just kept moving. Kept finding players in dangerous positions and eventually worked it into that spot where Paul Carson's taken the mark and just popped through the goal to get them to 13-10.
Look,
88, if my maths correct.
Yep.
Leopold's still 5-9-39.
I didn't pick up who it was, and I reckon it was Reed Adams, but someone just had a really good touch in there. It was clean as a whistle, which allowed that goal to happen. But Paul and Dale Carson show at the moment, isn't it?
Yeah, six goals between them. They're flying.
So three each. Is that correct?
Yep.
I'm not known for taking down the goal kickers, boys.
No, that's right. Well, they've got three straight each as well. They've missed today, the two Carson boys.
I just want to keep an eye out as the umpire's about to restart just to, for the gateway. I want to know those two games when we get a chance to. If we can keep a close eye on those, it'd be great. There's a free kick plucked out of the contest here, and it's Jai Walker's going to take it for Leopold in the centre of the ground. He kicks it long as he can, looking for Tom. Lovett goes back again with courage. He's done that a bit today. Tom got it, though. Got it to his teammate, Darcy Keese. Keese just boots it out of the pack, basically, and misses it to the left-hand side. And Joey's will restart play again through Jackman. Jackman dishes it off, though.
Yeah, Kershaw with the kick-in duties on this occasion. Just waiting for an option. He kicks it to himself. And he'll just give it a roost out to the outer side. And he'll look for a flyer at the back. Coming across the front, Leopold had numbers. At ground level, Tom, though, was able to gather it. His kick didn't go far. Lovick was there as well. Just shoveling it through the legs back and taking the balls to Latore. Handballed it off to the boundary line. Was a little bit close to them all. Love the throw in about 45 round from the Leopold goal.
Just quickly for the gateway, Newtown 11 points up against Grovedale at Burdoo Reserve. And Colac 2 points up against St Albans still.
Cracking game that one, obviously. So Ferguson for St Joey's on the right this time. Just clears it outside 50. Ball goes out of bounds. Leopold screaming out for a goal here. They trail by 8 straight goals at this stage. 48 points that'd be, boys. As ball thrown back in, it's Riley Kershaw. Goes forward. Walker again for Leopold, though. He's starting to get a bit of the footy. He's off the chain. Just gets it forward, looking there for Keast. Keast gets his hands on the footy. Gives it back. They transfer play across to this side. Oh, wow. Love it, though. Just with going back with a flight. Mark. Takes a cracking mark. Goes further afield to Davis. Davis just on the chest. He's held up here. Not much on for him. He's demanding people to run at him. He hasn't seen much. He just spots up a short one and done well. A nice little kick there, and it's Reed Adams.
Yeah, good mark by Reed Adams. Just took it nicely overhead with a bit of pressure coming from Burke. He chips it out wide on his left to Carras. He's going to bring the ball inside 50 now. He's got a lead from Carson. He's going to have to come from the back, and how about that? On our Joey McCullough on this occasion. He got the first grab, just reached out of the top, tapped it back to himself and took it on the second. And
well, Dowsett had front position then, and just Joey McCullough had the bigger reach. It's strange to be able to mark that so comfortably when you do have that front position, Jakey Dowsett.
Well, he didn't even really jump, did he? He just reached
sort of
over.
The reach was good, yeah. Similar position where Carras kicked his goal from earlier in the term, and we know how good a goal that was. Joe McCullough on this occasion just chips it up on his right boot, but he's just pulled it to the near side. One behind the St. Joey's as they move to 13-11, 89. Leopold 5-10, 40.
That's a shame.
Thanks to the 40-wing scoreboard.
It's a real shame you missed that, because that would have been a special celebration, you would have thought, as Walker brings it in, and he finds Churnside. Churnside just goes wide, close to the boundary line, looking for Dowsett. Dowsett with an awful-looking kick. It's cut off by Dale Carson. Goes across to his brother Paul. Paul further afield to Carras. Carras just slips in those fancy blue boots of his. He Arnell with just a little turn, but the ball's turned over. And Leopold are going to repel this attack. And there's the siren, and that'll beat all of them. Latore just had his ball, his hands on the ball there. So a really good quarter for St. Joseph's. They move to 13-11, 89. They're now 49 points in front of Leopold, 5-10, 40, thanks to 40 winks. And one would suggest this game's probably over, boys.
Yeah, you'd be a brave man to suggest it wasn't. Well, that was that's scary. St. Joey's had just dismantled the second best side in the comp.
And with relative
with
ease, yes.
Yep.
Absolutely. So let's dissect that after a quick break, and let's get our sponsors. Leopold finally in position. Any changes we can pick up, boys, at all?
Just having a look.
Not as yet.
No, doesn't look like it.
As he raises the ball aloft, they certainly need a big 5 minutes here. As Berry goes up, it's Hovey who wins that one. Gets it out, looking there for Hickey. Can't get it out, though. Thompson, of course, at the bottom of the pack, as he does. Carras in there as well, gets his hands on it, but it's Berry who eventually extracts it. He goes out the back to Churnside. Churnside's been wrapped up beautifully by Haynes, and Haynes is going to get the free kick, and he's going to drive Joey's straight into attack again. Haynes is an exciting talent, That's not a great kick, not his best effort, but eventually it found its way there to Carson. Carson, an exploratory handball. Leopold just scrapping and scrambling. There's a little bit of a tunnel there, and he's hurt too, the St. Joey's player. Pretty stiff, probably could have got a free kick. Foss, he got his legs stripped out from under him.
Yeah, he did. Yeah. That's exactly what the rule was brought in for, I thought, when your legs are taken out from underneath you, but no free kick paid, as you mentioned.
Yeah, it was quite dangerous, actually. The ball's going to be bounced, though, right in front of the AL Russell Pavilion. Joey's in attack. It's a double-handed fist pump out of the ruck there, and that has been a free kick for a hold, yeah. And he is not far out from goal. It's Geordie Kerris.
Yep. He's dangerous around goal, Geordie Kerris.
Donovan Casey.
Who is also dangerous around goal. They've got Jake Dowsett playing as the deepest defender, and I suspect that's not where or how Leopold would want to structure up, having him in the last line of defence. So they're trying to expose him and get a free kick immediately from the get-go.
Just looking at the crowd behind the goals, boys, there's a big crowd here today. Joey's look like their following's increased fivefold from what I can remember a couple of years ago, maybe a little bit of success. A couple of people here.
Well, why wouldn't you jump on their coattails when they're playing like this, Walt?
It's irresistible footy, isn't it?
And it's got to be a concern for Leopold at the moment. This one really looks like it could blow out to, you know, an 80-point sort of deficit at the way it's going. We're at 55 already, and you'd back Joey's at the moment, kick another five or six.
Well, Buzz, you mentioned it. One versus two here, too. I mean, this is a genuine show of strength. So it's Berry again with a dinky little tap even. Got out there by McCoola, though. Just cleared it for Joey's. Off hands. It is kicked in there by Hickey. Hickey got the footy deep again. It's John O'Casey once again trying to track the footy, but bundled over the line by Dowsett on this occasion. And we're back in the same position we were about 1 minute ago, straight in front of the Russell Pavilion.
Yeah, once again, dangerous for Leopold again. St. Joey's been so good in these situations all day. They love that contested style of game in close. You'd expect them to fly out of here as it's thrown back into play. Berry got the tap, but once again, they rove it brilliantly. Again, it's Haynes Stose on the right, just towards the top of the square. Needs a mark here. Great work by Riley Ferguson, and we'll be watching. Well, we're in a good position right behind him here to see his left foot at work.
Mark this one down, boys. He's got delightful skills, this boy.
Wow.
Oh,
that's out in the
big
limb.
Call.
Perfect for the left foot up. 45 degree out, 40 metres.
Here he goes, on the left, yep.
Thanks for coming.
Oh, that's
too easy, isn't it?
What about the spin of that footy? Did that even not spin pure at any point?
Tell you what, Wally, you just get really, really up and about whenever he goes near it.
He's going to go give him his number later.
Oh, I reckon.
He has got delightful foot skills, that boy.
Very, very good player, Riley Ferguson. Got him from Geelong Amateurs. Geelong Amateurs boy originally for this season. Just another great inclusion for St. Joey's.
So for 40 winks, what's the margin, boys? Have we got the scoreboard attendants are lazy over there. They're giving me nothing.
They are struggling at the minute as the ball's already gone back in the middle of the play and we're back underway. Leopold, they tried to get it out of there with a quick kick off the ground. Couldn't do so eventually. That was Hickey trying to thump it on the boot forward. Jai Thompson went and gathered it on his left. His kick up the ground. Well, he was looking for, I think it may have been Hardy, but Lovick cut it off and then went for a bit of a run. He's poked it out to the far side. Going to get there first for Leopold. There was Jaden McHenry, and he smashed in a tackle and gains a free kick. And there's a little bit of feeling on that far side.
They're not happy. There was Alex Hickey who performed the high hit. They went after him.
So the ball in Leopold's forward 50. Joey's, though, got the numbers to work it out there quickly. Riley Ferguson gets it on the boot and goes up the line to Jimmy Allen. Pushes back off the mark. Just waiting for someone to present up the field. Eventually gets a lead from Dale Carson. The kick went over his head. Was taken well by Foss. He's had plenty of it today.
He's playing like a 6'4" bloke.
Yeah, well, when you're running around and jumping up and taking in the hands like that, yeah, you're playing well above his, he's playing well above his height at the moment. He goes to a contest inside forward 50 at ground level. Berry playing the rover role on this occasion. Gave it off to McHenry at Joey's, though. They're trying to apply a bit of pressure and lock it up in there. Ball now with Marcus Thompson. Leopold work it out of there and get it out to the centre wing.
Kick was no good, though. It was cut off by measures. It was too much heat on the ball. It'll go out to Wally's man in Ferguson, but the kick was smothered. Surprise, surprise. The ball will come to ground. Jai Walker just couldn't pick it up cleanly. Miller, wonderful smother. That's desperation. They've got this game in the bag and they're still flying themselves around. Foss's first to this one. He attracts a crowd quickly, still gets his hands free. Holgren's there too with Walker, but the umpire will ball it up 48 out from home.
Well, Buzz, that smother was John O'Casey. And look, at any stage of the match, it's great to see your forwards doing that. But at this time, the game's over, and that was just wonderful.
Yep, it was superb. Here's Ferguson again. He was held on to, and he will get a free kick. He did that well. He just protected the space of the footy. He knew what he was doing. He would pump it inside 50. He was 55 out. Dowsett gets led to the footy again, and there's good hands by his opponent.
Paul
it is
Carson.
Paul Carson. So they've isolated that matchup, as I mentioned before. They've got Dowsett to Joe's and managed to get Dowsett as the deepest forward, which Leopold did not want. And Carson, Paul, lining up for goal number 4.
This is a test for the perfect record for the Carson stay.
It is a test, but I don't want to influence your votes post-game, boys, but Paul Carson for mine, he is going to be hard to beat, let me tell you.
So Carson comes in, didn't look amazing off the boot, and it wasn't. No one on the goal line, they just expected it to fly through, but it was hung out to the right just for a behind. So the first blemish is, as you mentioned, Jim, on the Carson scoreboard.
Just me, or could that ball have been marked in front of the points there?
If someone had been there.
Could have been.
It's always the way, isn't it, when you're kicking a goal from across the face sort of thing, you have someone on that point post just for that one that fades out there. Leopold bring the ball back into play. They're going to Berry. He's been their target with the kickings on a few occasions today. Guy O'Keefe was there. He couldn't pick it up. Keres gets in there as well. Strong tackle, but Keres eventually gets the handball out the back. He was trying to get Josh Hovey to barge through. Now ground level, Leopold. They've got the numbers. That was Matty Miller. Now it's with a Guy O'Keefe with all the class in there. Gets it on the left boot. Moves it up the ground. Hardy was in the front position there, and he's going to get the free kick as Lovick just put his hand over his shoulder. And Hardy can just chip it further afield. He's got a couple options there. It's Joel Thompson and Guy O'Keefe. Two pretty handy footballers to choose from. Thompson with the tape wrapped around his head will move the ball on now. He's going to have to try to run around Lovick. He gives the hands off and running away with the ball now. Sammy Hughes gets away from Lovick, puts on the left boot, spears it in, but it was intercept mark from Jacko Davis, who goes to switch the play for St. Joey's. They got numbers on the outer side. But good fist coming across there from Marcus Thompson. Then gathers the ball. He'll swing back on. They can attack again, Leopold. His kick wasn't great. But once again, Joey's will rebound out of there, as they have done for majority of the day.
So it was Foss who brought it out, but only as far as Marcus Thompson. Thompson gets it inside 50 again for Leopold, and they're doing a little bit of attacking here. It was Tom, ball just rolled off the end of his hand though, and the free kick's going to go to Capra. Capra transfers play, centre of the ground, about full back position, should I say. It is Thompson, Jai, who intercepted and just hooked it around his body towards goal, and that is all clear. Jai Thompson just creates something out of nothing there. And he is a star performer, no doubt. That St. Joseph's had control of that footy.
It was a very poor kick, wasn't it?
Yeah.
The short one.
Dreyer just went a little bit cute then, in his deep in his own defence. So on the Ballarat Tigers scoreboard, Joey's 15-12-102. Leopold with their first goal in a quarter and a half almost. 6-10-46.
Boy, did they need that one.
Underselling it a little bit well, I think.
Absolutely. So up they go again, and it's Berry against Holgren this time. Ball shuffled forward. It's going to be O'Keefe on the left foot. Gets it deep inside 50. Lovick then called out of it. I think it was Latore, is it, who took a good mark. Gets it further afield, and Foss takes a good mark. An overhead mark, as he has done for about the seventh time today. He just kicks it further field short. John O'Casey, who's been pretty handy also. He's going to transfer into the centre of the ground, switch it. Find his man, Alex Hickey, there. Hickey kicks inside 50. Not a great kick, but finding, in the end, Timmy Arnell, a good mark against a couple of Leopold defenders there.
I'm not sure if Nick Bird got called out of that or not, but he had good position to come in third man. He had the front spot. He just needed to get himself in front of Timmy Arnell to stop him, because he actually marked it pretty easily in the end.
Almost uncontested amongst a couple of opponents. Interesting. So he's going to line up from about 45 metres here, Tim Arnell. pretty much dead in front. If distance isn't a worry, you'd probably expect him to kick it. As he comes in, he's hooked it, or sorry, he's sliced it to the right though, and it's only just snuck in for a behind.
So still only the 7 goal scorers for St. Joe's today, which is a fair feat to have kicked 15 goals.
Mm.
So Leopold, they bring the ball back into play, taking the mark there with Matthew Pitt. He hasn't got much to go to, so he goes short to Sammy Hughes on the lead. He's going to switch it out to the far side. He's got numbers calling for it. Kick was going to Matty Miller. Couldn't quite get there. Easy Holcomb cut it off, put on the pressure, and got the ball over the boundary line about 55 around from St. Joey's goal.
When you're ready, Buzz, we'll just go around the grounds for the gateway, please. Yep. Those two close ones in particular.
So the ball thrown back into play. The ruckman will do battle again. It's Holcomb, who's had a little bit more of an influence in the second half. He got the tap to the front, but eventually the clearing kick out of that contest came for Matty Pitt. Went up the ground, out the back. There was Kershaw. Tried to get the ball moving for St. Joe's. Couldn't do so. It's tied up on the boundary line. Eventually, it works its way over the line. Once again, we'll have a throw in centre wing.
Newtown, 8 points up against Grovedale. Well, in that close one. North Shore, a goal up on Geelong West.
Cool.
And Colac have also got a goal up against St. Albans. So,
right,
some good
three
games in the making.
Nice. So, over the top third man out was Nick Burke. Smashed it further afield and did well. Miller's running onto it. He also does well, traps the footy, and finds his teammate there. Out in front is James Bennett. Bennett just wheels around, and like Capra was the forward, Capra for St. Joseph's intercept marks, and does really well on that occasion. Gets it further afield now. I think that's Haynes, locked up against the boundary, looking for Casey. It goes over his head, goes over everyone now. Onto the footy first is Michael Murray. He flipped it across to his teammate, Marcus Thompson. Thompson with a really short kick but missed his target. And Joey's got the ball again. They're going to attack through now through McCullough. McCullough to Foss. Foss into the centre of the ground and good mark, Reed Adams. Under a bit of pressure there from Thompson. Reed Adams just gets around him. Nicely worked. Kicks it deep into forward. He's got Carson. He just chooses to punch though from behind. It was a good option in the end. And he caused a boundary throw-in about 15 metres from the right goalpost, St. Joseph's.
Did well, St. Joe's. They could have easily lost possession of that footy, but they just kept it going forward. Foss and McCullough in particular were excellent as the ball comes back in and come over the back. Holcomb helps it on its way to McCullough. Nearly a high fend-off against him. He came barging in, but attracts three Leopold players, and he is wrapped up. It's about 15 out from St. Joe's goal. They're in a very attacking position, a strong position, as Holcomb over the top again. Nearly fell to Reed Adams on his left side too. That would have been dangerous. He comes again and comes really hard. Comes out to Holcomb, who's snapping on the right boot, but he just ballies it, yeah, and it will fly.
Nothing attempt that in the end.
Not his best effort, fair to say.
He found himself a bit of space too, tucked in on the boundary. But no good.
Just quick AFL update too for Carlton fans. They've had their first win in Australia.
Yes.
Season 2015.
Yes.
That's massive. So it's McHenry. He's going to transfer play, cross ground, and it's a nice little spot up target to Darcy Keast. Keast, who's done a bit of voluntary or a relief ruck work. Unfortunately, though, they cough it up, and it's Daniel Lovick. Lovick, who's probably been a bit quieter today than his usual standards. Expect a lot of him, but he's kicked a nice little pass here to Reed Adams, who will line up for goal by the look of it.
Just a couple of times the Leopold forwards are getting led to the footy by their opponents. It's extraordinary.
So Reed Adams, from 50 out, made a wise decision not to shoot him up, but unfortunately he's kicked it to Jai Walker for Leopold. Taking the mark 20 metres out from St. Joseph's goal. He's been pretty solid today, Walker. Tried hard. Goes looking for his teammate, and finding him in the end, I think, was Tim Conley, but he bundled his teammate out of the way, no? It's gone to Pitt.
Interesting passage of play there with Pitt ending up with the ball as he brings it back towards the centre of the ground, tracking back there. He was looking for Pitcher. Was cut off. Running onto it was
Hickey.
He throws it on the boot. His kick went long. Carson couldn't quite take the mark down the line. Now we've got a player down here too. Is that Larkham a bit sore in the goal square?
Yeah. He got bodied by Dale Carson, and he's very slow to move. He wouldn't be the sort of guy that would stay down too, Jeremy Larkham.
I reckon it's just a winding though. I reckon he's got one in the cage.
Yeah, he's hunched over at the moment. He Looks like he's, yeah, I think you might be right, Wall. He's just trying to suck in the big ones.
Either that or it could be the other sweet spot.
It could be.
Not sure.
The ball's brought back regardless. Jackman will fly over the top, just couldn't quite hold it. It falls to Kevin Burke, who's failed in the second half, but he's just been starved of opportunity down forward. The ball's parried over the line out of bounds, nearly deliberate, but the umpire won't pay it at this stage.
Larkham's going to come off here, boys. In the hands of two trainers, very slowly coming off as well.
Yeah.
It doesn't look to be leg related.
It's not good. They've had to get Anthony Churnside to mark Dale Carson too in the hard defence, which probably wasn't in the script. Lovick will win this though. It's in Joey's back line, but they'll transfer it quick enough. It's out to your man, Wal Ferguson, and just showing off in front of you too. He goes on his right peg, if you don't mind. Finds Foss. He's right in front of us. He'll just drive it long. Burke's got the sit and marks. Just on his own defensive 50.
Quiet second half for Burke. He was really good early on today.
He was. He got plenty of it.
But just like his side, as they faded, he's faded as well.
Yeah, spot on. He's run himself in a little bit of trouble. Didn't know what to do with it. He ends up running across goal and drives on his left foot.
Terrible.
It's not the wisest thing I've ever seen. Churnside made it look okay in the end, but then shoved off it. It was poor effort by Berry. Just got rid of his man too eagerly. It's Holgren.
Carson.
He's about, Carson, sorry, 60 out, just pumps it in over the top. Nearly a good mark. Rove well, sharked well. And the shot on goal, I think it was Haynes in the end on his left foot, but the snap was no good.
Geordie Kerris looked dangerous in the air there, third man up. Just couldn't quite grab it.
Kicking a goal hasn't been great for St. Joey's today. 15-15 for them now as they move to 105.
And so we just had word, Jeremy Larkham, he's just been taken straight up the race into the rooms there for Leopold, so he'll take no further part in the game, you would have thought.
Do you think it was ribs, Wal?
Yeah, I do. I think definitely upper body, not lower, for me. As the ball's kicked out, out from full back, it's Kevy Burke's going to be on the end of it. He's just going to wheel around. He wheels around to his left and then kicks it onto his right. He's done that a couple of times today, which is interesting. But Joey's are going to win back possession here.
We've got Joey's player down too.
Yeah, there
centre
is.
Wing.
It's not good.
Very slow to get up.
John O'Casey just extracted that. Let me know who that is when you pick it up. It's Latore, is it? Tom Latore?
Yeah, Latore.
He's just going to jog from the ground though.
No point sending him back out if he's a little bit sore. You'd think at this time of the game we couldn't have too long left in the...
Put him in, Cottonwall. The umpire throws up the ball again. It's Berry, as he has done for most of the day. Only as far as Haynes, so ball smothered off his boot though and kicked forward by a Leopold player. It is in the end Tim Conley who's ran onto it. He's got the ball over the top. Dangerous position here. Capra, well done. Spoilt Tom. But couldn't get the ball out of bounds though. It was hacked off the ground by Kevy Burke. Couldn't quite get it through. He gets another shot at it. And this time, what's going on? It's like pinball in the goal square.
I'll tell you what, Dan Lovick, he actually made three saves.
I think you're right. That was like goalkeeper.
There was three attempts off the ground, and Lovick saved them all Mark Schwarzer style.
That is amazing play, but down there.
I think the Leopold forwards need to work on their soccer skills, though. They've nailed three from about 4 metres and hit him
on
the chest three times in a row.
So Alex Hickey kicks the ball long out of St. Joseph's back line, clears the play out nicely, but it's Jai Walker who just gets the ball moving Leopold's way again. It was Berry who got the ball at ground level and did well. Got it off to O'Keefe, but the ball's wrestled out of his hands and St. Joey's have kicked it forward. Free kick off the play here. And the ball
in the back to Murray, I think.
Yeah, so Michael Murray on half back now for Leopold. Just goes laterally, finds his man there in Thompson, Marcus. Marcus kicks it all the way to inside 50, but it's Hickey again. Just flicked it somehow to Lovick. Lovick transfers play. Little bit of pressure on here, but well done. It was Dreyer. Got it over the top quickly to Jimmy Allen. Allen's got a paddock. He can take bounces, and he does. He takes one. Just jogging, though. He's found a target, and it's Carson. Dale just tried to get the sit. Couldn't quite get it. It's Foss again for the 50th time today. He just flicks it across to his teammate. Kerris at ground level. Picks the ball off his shoe straps on the right, goes looking for goal, and the ball has been marked in the goal square by Dale Carson.
Protected the space well, didn't he? Knew that the fall of the ball was going to happen. He's got a good matchup, though. He's got Churnside with Larkham
off the
going
ground.
Off.
Your outlandish statement, Buzz, was it Dale or Paul Carson?
It was Dale. I think I hedged my bets and just said both. I don't know. I think it might have been Dale. It was Dale,
but this is for number four.
Thanks for coming.
And no Dale mistakes. Carson does just that. And the scoreboard ticks on to St. Joseph's, 111. And they are big leaders over St. Joseph's, 47 for Ballerine Tyres.
And once again, for the umpteenth time, transition from defence to forward. There is almost zero pressure on St. Joey's when they move the footy from one end to the other. And it's been startling today.
It's that sort of play that makes you wonder why they can't get it done on Simmons Stadium. Open spaces, you'd think it just suit that really quick running, flowing game style that they can get going. And
this is a difference in St. Joseph's side to what we've seen in the past. Yep. So look out for it this year anyway. So Hovey and Berry, the ball just smashes straight up back in the air. It's Kerris who's got his hands first on it. He couldn't bring it to ground though. He bursts through the pack again, has another crack at it though. Haynes also gets on the end of it. But Jai Thompson again, tackled well by Reed Adams. Got it to Miller though. Matty Miller just flicked it across now to douse it. And the ball ends up in Miller's hands, but it's only as far as Hovey. And Hovey gets the ball inside 50. Joey's looking dangerous here. Leopold's got the numbers, but Joey's got one out the back. He just tried to do too much, though, Timmy Arnell. Had a teammate in support, didn't use him. And that is a ridiculous attempt to play advantage rule from the Leopold player there.
Just quickly for the Gateway Hotel. Well, just 1 point separating Newtown and Grovedale.
Oh, I love
and
it.
The same margin for Geelong West North Shore.
Oh, that's fantastic. As Berry takes a good strong mark on half back there. Got his hands up very high, the big man. He's just an up and under kick. I'm not sure what happened then with Hardy.
Hardy didn't fly for the mark, did he?
It was a little bit strange, but it's Jai Thompson who's going to get possession back for Leopold on the half back flank. He just goes laterally to Churnside, who's got a little bit of space. Finds it again. Laterally one more time. Long way away, that one, boys. I'd say it's McHenry who's got the footy in his hands.
And I'd agree with you.
Kicks it down the line, but well marked there of St. Joseph's player. And they're going to transfer laterally down this side of the ground. And it's well played. It's measures. He's got plenty of space. And he's got a teammate in Haynes all by himself. It bounces past him. And it's McCullough grabs it, though. Handballs it inside. Finds Haynes. And, they're on. They just couldn't quite take the mark. And it was well done there by Hughes.
That
just shuffled it at his teammate.
The first one Foss has put down all day,
I reckon. Yeah, you're dead right. And it's Walker, Jai, who clears the ball for Leopold. Only as far as, looking for Keast. He gets it on to Miller. Miller goes long, and in best position here was Tom. It was well sport in the end by the St. Joey's defence. Ball falls down to Hovey. Gets it on to his teammate and in the centre of the ground here. I think that's Arnell, isn't it? Arnell goes and finds McCullough. Really good Joey McCullough. Gets up rather slowly, but he's going to have a shot on goal about 40 metres out.
Will this finally be his look-at-me moment?
I can tell you he's not going to pass it because he has got his back to the play and has had for the last 20 or so seconds.
Poor old Jakey Dowsett has been put through the ringer this afternoon. He's had plenty of men filter through. But he's had a tough afternoon. He's probably played a little bit bigger than he would have liked.
And, of course, Joey's 31 scoring shots to date, so it's been down there thick and fast. So McCullough, that's straight through the middle, boys.
Oh, just a cobra! Oh, and he's given a little uppercut too. Oh, Joey.
He's happy with himself there.
And in hindsight, we've gone to the wrong game here anyway. So a Drew reserve. St. Joseph 16-15, 117. They're now 70-point leaders over Leopold, who are 6-11-47 on the Ballarine Tyres scoreboard.
We got anything further on the other games?
I was thinking, on close inspection, Joe McCullough, I think he's just got your average Kmart black socks on. Just looking, they've got some sort of funny logo on the back. They're definitely
really?
not St. Joey's socks. So got some silver lining on the back of them.
So Berry got the fist in the ruck. Trying to get it out. There was Jimmy Allen at ground level now. The umpire's found a free kick. It'll go the way of Leopold. And unsurprisingly, it's Joe Thompson who'll take it. You'd back him to find a target here. He just chips it to Berry. Now Berry moves it on quickly. He's going to go deep towards the pocket. Tom's in a good position. Couldn't take the mark. At the front was Capra once again. But Burke with a quick kick at goal.
Is all clear.
It's not a bad finish. So Leopold, they get their seventh, 7-11, 53. St. Joe's 17-15-117. And that scoreboard is thanks to Ballerine Tyres.
And for the Gateway Hotel, Grovedale have retaken the lead against Newtown. That one's seesawing at Burda Reserve. It's 91-86 in that. Geelong West, 1 point lead over North Shore, 94 plays 93. And Colac, a 1 point lead over St. Albans, 25 minutes played in that one, 65-64.
Some cracking contests there, boys. Cracking contest. As it's once again, it's Hovey and Berry. No one wins that one. Berry got his hands on it, but was well tackled there by Hovey. Out though, Reed Adams got it out to his teammate. But eventually, it's going to be Kevy Burke who extracts a footy for Leopold. Gets it inside 50, but it's just hacked off the ground in by the St. Joseph's defence. Haynes runs onto it, finds Hickey. Hickey across now to Reed Adams. Adams on the left boot. Goes inside. This is a good build-up from Joey's. It's roved off the pack by McCooler on the right
out.
Foot.
Oh, and here he comes.
Watch
look at
out.
Him. Boom. Oh, bang. Another uppercut.
He needs to lift his game. He can't be doing the same celebration twice.
Oh, listen, that's sure a lovely about. Roving effort, though. Really well played by Joey McCooler, but it was probably just as impressive with St. Joseph's build-up right from inside Leopold's 50.
Yep.
Yeah, it's impressive.
And I think initially it was James Allen who started it. The sunk his slipper into it off the deck and got it going St. Joseph's way. So, and they are an impressive unit.
Oh, that's been generous. They have been awesome today, St. Joey's. 8-15-123 to Leopold 7-11 on the Ballerine Tyres scoreboard. Well,
yeah, outstanding stuff. Umpire restarts again. Couldn't be long left in this match, I wouldn't have thought. It's just the intensity's gone out of it a touch.
There couldn't be long left, but it looks like the sun's finally starting to creep through in a few little patches.
It's not any warmer.
Hopefully we reach double figures shortly. As McCooler doing it all. Hacks it out from the centre break. And, he snatched that footy. It was Ferguson, I think, who snatched it out of the Leopold hand. Found Dale Carson. The mark wasn't paid for some reason. It's Davis who just goes back looking for Foss. Foss is going to run onto the footy. Wheel around on the right. He's got a couple of players to fly here, and it's beautifully done there by Paul Carson. That was strength in the air, and he's taken a really good mark. I could almost give that a Palais Bingo contender, but you boys would probably pull me up on it.
Yep.
Yeah, we would.
he slipped over and it fell on his lap. That's what happened.
I'll tell you what he did. He got rid of his opponent there with sheer strength, and it took all his might, and he was on the deck, and he just took it in the chest. I thought it was outstanding.
Yep. Well, as well, and St. Joey's have been outstanding too as the siren goes. He comes in for goal.
So Paul Carson makes, the crowd behind the goals
the
liked it.
The on-ball has liked it.
The on-ball is down there to test their eyes, I reckon.
But he's just slid that across the face. And that is the ball game, boys. And, we've seen a well-oiled unit here, I would have thought. It's St. Joseph's victors. They win the game 19-15, 123, I reckon that might be 124 though after that point, versus Leopold 7-11. Oh, they're just all over me here, the scoreboard attendance. 53.
I reckon they're tearing it down.
So the final margin, help me out please, I think that's going to be 71 points, isn't it? Yes,
yeah,
it is.
That sounds right to me, Bob.
71 big ones, so I might have been the closest, but we'll talk about that soon, because firstly, we're going to take a break. And we'll come back and dissect this game. And, of course, we'll go around the grounds and find out just what happens elsewhere as well.